Hello students, welcome to the new session of Social Science. Today we will be learning about the globe, a model of the earth, which is your first chapter. Have you ever thought what if the shape of the earth was flat and what would happen to a person who reaches the edge of the earth and continues walking? Yes, he would surely fall off, but nobody has ever fallen off the earth in this way. What does this show? Yes, it shows that the shape of the earth is round. But when you look around, it appears to be flat. It is because the earth is so much bigger than us. We can only see short distance at a time. To see the curving surface of the earth, you would have to see it from a higher distance. For example, the picture shows that the earth is seen from the space. So here, you could see the earth's curving surface from higher distance at space. Now, as the earth is bigger than us, how are we going to study about the earth? The large size of the earth makes it difficult to study it as a whole. So, the geographers have developed different means of representing Earth on a smaller scale, like globes and maps, to make its study easy. Globe is a small model of the Earth, and map is a drawing of the Earth's surface. As said, the globe is a small model of the Earth. It shows the shape and location of the continents, oceans, seas, countries and important cities. You can only see half of the globe at one time, as you have to turn the globe around to see the other half. The globe can be turned around with the help of a line passing through it, which is called as the axis. Axis is not a straight line. It is tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees. So is the earth. The earth constantly rotates or turns around the axis of rotation, tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees to the vertical. The axis of rotation of the globe is similar to that of the earth. As you can see in this image, the two end points of the axis of rotation are called the poles. To the north is the North Pole and to the south is the South Pole. After meeting the poles in the previous life, moving on to the midway between the poles, there is an imaginary line circling the earth, which divides the earth into two halves. The imaginary line is called as equator. Each half is called as hemisphere. To the north of the equator is northern hemisphere, and to the south of the equator is southern hemisphere. As we have seen that the equator is an imaginary line, there are many other lines which are vertical and horizontal that goes around the globe. These lines are called as latitudes and longitudes. These lines help in locating the places on the globe. The latitudes and longitudes cut each other at right angles. They are marked in degree and minutes. 60 minutes equals to 1 degree. Let us learn more about latitudes. The horizontal line drawn parallel to the equator around the earth is called as latitudes or parallels. Let us know more about latitudes by going through its features. Latitudes run parallel to each other in the east-west direction. They are at an equal distance from each other. All of them form complete circles except North Pole and the South Pole, which are points. The latitudes decrease in length as you move from the equator to the poles. As we already have got an idea about latitudes, let's learn how to mark latitudes. Please observe the picture given below. Equator is marked at 0 degrees. North Pole is marked at 90 degrees to the north. and South Pole is marked at 90 degree to the south. The latitude of a place tells you how far north or south a place is from an equator. For example, a place with latitude of 45 degree north is located in northern hemisphere, midway between the equator and the North Pole. A place at a latitude of 60 degree north is further north. This shows that as there is an increase in a degree, the latitude moves away from the equator. In total, there are 180 degrees of latitudes. 90 of them lies in northern hemisphere and other 90 lies in southern hemisphere. There are four more important latitudes. Arctic Circle at 66.5 degree north. Tropic of Cancer at 23.5 degree north. Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degree south. Antarctic Circle at 66.5 degree south. Now let us learn about longitudes. The vertical lines that are semicircles which run from North Pole to the South Pole are called as longitudes or meridian. Let us learn more about longitudes through its features. Longitudes are semicircles that run from one place to another. They run in a true north-south direction. They are spaced farthest apart at the equator and comes together to a point at the poles. As we have got an idea about longitudes from the previous slide, let us know more about marking of longitudes. The longitude running through the Old Royal Observatory at Greenwich near London is marked as 0 degree. It is called as the Greenwich Meridian or Prime Meridian. There are total 360 degrees of longitude. 180 degrees of longitude to the east of meridian and 180 degrees of longitude to the west of meridian. The 180 degrees of east and the 180 degrees of west of longitude that meet and form a single line on the opposite side of the world called as the 180 degree longitude or international date line. Thus, the longitude of a place tells you how much east or west of the Greenwich Meridian the place is located. What will happen if we draw horizontal line and on top of it we draw vertical line? Yes, it will form boxes. Likewise, the latitudes and longitudes together form a network of lines on the globe. This network of lines are called as grid. This is known as global grid. If we know the longitude and the latitude of a place, we can locate the place accurately with the help of global grid. Thank you.